ဲ့တော့စစရင်တို့ဘာပြောမလဲဆိုရင်ဒါ highway and traffic engineering this is a highway and traffic engineering we were going to design a highway and traffic so we had to utilize the engineering so the methods to utilize the engineering design is American Association of State Highway and Transport Officials ASHTO design methods those are ASHTO design methods are utilized for the flexible pavement design on the highway and traffic are important is a pavement design important the pavement design is a flexible must be the flexible so in this case we utilize the ASHTO design method ASHTO means the American Association of the State Highway and Transport Official the method is utilized for to design the flexible pavement so,highway နဲ့ traffic မှာဆိုရင်အရေးကြီးဆုံးကဆိုရင် line အဆောင်တွေအကွေ့တွေနေရာတွေရှိတယ်အဲ့တော့ line အဆောင်အကွေ့တွေနေရာတွေကိုပုံစံပြုဖို့အရေးကြီးတယ်ဘာကြောင့်ကားတွေအချိန်အားဆိုရင်အဲ့ဒီ line အဆောင်အကွေ့တွေအားဆိုရင်ကားအချိန်နဲ့ကန့်ညီဖို့လိုတယ်အဲ့အဲ့တော့ line အဆောင်တွေအကွေ့တွေတိဆောက်ဖို့လာဆိုရင်ဒါ flexible pavement design လို့ခေါ်တယ်အဲ့အဲ့မှာ ASHTO design method ကိုအသုံးပြုတယ် ASHTO ကတော့ဘာလဲဆိုရင် American เนาะပြည်နယ်တွေရဲ့ဒီလို keyway လမ်းကြီးတွေတိဆောက်ဖို့เนาะအဲ့ဒီအဖွဲ့အစည်းမှာရှိတဲ့เนาะတောင်ရှိတဲ့လူတွေရဲ့ပုံစံပြုထားတဲ့ design method အဲ့ဒါကိုအသုံးပြုမှာဖြစ်တယ် So when we are making the design considerations we have to concern about the pavement performance also we need to concern about traffic road bed size and subgrade materials and materials of the construction environment drainage and reliability those things have to be then concern about pavement performance and how that we design the pavement performance what are the level of traffic and also the robust size the subgrade materials are the quality need to be concerned about and required material for the road construction environment condition drainage and for the water come into the runways or in this case the water need to be taken away so drainage system is important aspect also there's a reliability those factors are need to be concerned for the design consideration အဲ့တော့ပုံစံပြုလုပ်တဲ့အခါမှာဆိုတော့အချက်လက်တွေကိုထည့်သွင်းစဉ်းစားဖို့လိုတယ်။အဲ့ဒီအခါမှာ line အကွေ့တွေမှာဆိုရင်တော့ pavement တွေရဲ့ဆောင်ရွက်မှုတွေအဲလမ်းပေါ်မှာသွားတဲ့ရင်တွေနဲ့ပတ်သက်တာတွေနောက်ပြီးတော့ line ရဲ့အောက်ခြေမှာရှိတဲ့မြေနဲ့ပတ်သက်တဲ့အချက်လက်တွေနောက်ပြီးတော့လမ်းတည်ဆောက်ဖို့ထွက်ရလိုအပ်တဲ့ပစ္စည်းကိရိယာတွေနောက်တစ်ခါလမ်းမှာအသုံးပြုတဲ့ပတ်ဝန်းကျင်အခြေအနေတွေနောက်ပြီးရေထုတ်ပဲပဲစနစ်တွေနောက်ပြီးစိတ်ချမှုအဆင့်တွေအဲ့ဒါတွေအကုန်လုံးကတော့ပုံစံပြုတဲ့အခါမှာစဉ်းစားရမှာဖြစ်တယ်Then we concern about this pavement performance. So the pavement performance depending on the structure of the performance, they are related to the physical condition, cracking, faulting, and revealing. So in this case, the road structure is an important aspect. The road must not be cracked. So in this case, structural performance is we need to avoid the cracking, faulting, and revealing. So the structural performance related to the physical condition. In the meantime, the functional performance need to be concerned about. In this case, the riding cars or riders need to be comfortability. So the effectiveness of pavement serves the user and how the pavements are effectively provided the comfortability to the user. So this is how effectively the pavement serves the user. Those are the functional performance.So in this case, another thing is a pavement performance is a serviceability is a performance. In this case, serviceability is a performance from the 0 to 5. And based on the rustiness and distress, cracking the patient not rust, we also have to be concerned about the pavement performance based on the rustiness and distress, cracking patient and rust.အဲ့တော့လမ်းပေးမဲ့တည်းရဲ့ဆောင်ရွက်မှုကိုစဉ်းစားတဲ့အခါမှာဆိုတော့ဖွဲ့စည်းတည်ဆောက်မှုဆိုင်ရာဘလို့တော့ဆောင်ရွက်မှုပေးတယ်အဲ့ဒီခါမှာဆိုရင်တော့ကားမှာဆိုရင်ဘလို့လမ်းပေးမဲ့တည်းရဆိုရင်တော့ကွဲအပ်တာလေးဖြစ်နေတာတော့အမားယူနေဖြစ်နေတာအဲ့ဒီချက်ကိုလည်းစဉ်းစားရမှာဖြစ်တယ်နောက်ပြီးအဲ့ဒီကားလမ်းပေးဖက်တွေမှာဆိုရင်ကားကမောင်းနေတယ်အဲ့ကားစီးသေးတဲ့လူတွေရဲ့တက်ဆောင်ဖြစ်မှုကိုလည်းစဉ်းစားရမှာဖြစ်တယ်အဲ့ဒါတော့ဒါ functional performance လို့ခေါ်တယ်အဲ့ဒီခါမှာဆိုရင်ပေးမဲ့နေဆောက်လုပ်တဲ့အခါမှာဆိုတော့ဘလောက်တော့သူတို့ပြည်ပြင်ထိန်းသိမ်းနိုင်မလဲအဲ့အဲ့ဒီခါမှာ PSIR 0 to 5ဟိုဇရာကိုသုံးမှာဖြစ်တယ်အဲနောက်ကလမ်းကဘလောက်ချမ်းသလဲဘလောက်အခက်အခဲရှိသလဲအဲအဲ့ဒီအချက်တွေကိုလည်းပဲထည့်သွင်းပြီးတော့မှတော့စဉ်းစားရမှာဖြစ်တယ်ဒါက the two serviceability indices so initial serviceability index PI and the terminal serviceability index PD two index need to be utilized so in this case initial serviceability index PI serviceability index immediately after the construction of pavement so this is for the initial serviceability index PI so in this case after the construction of pavements we have to concern about the serviceability index So PI is a 4x2. The 4x2 is usually 4x5 for the good condition. So based on this, the existing condition, we can rate the serviceability index. At the time, we know serviceability index ka blow no longan pisao nai le so pyo de a lo patama song no mula chi ni ma chi de no di longan pisao nai mu di no nao song chi ni ma chi de longan pisao nai mu di ai a che na che wo yu ya me a lo patama song chi ni ma chi de longan pisao nai mu da initial serviceability pi so lo ba so yin di lo pe mae wo pisao pi de kha ma blow no kaung kaung mon pe nai de le a lo phop ya de a lo pon ma pi lo 4x2 chi de Initial serviceability index is based on the class of the highway. In this case, 0.25 or 3 for the major highway, 2 for the lower class highway, and 1x5 for the economic constraints performance PDI may be reduced. So those are the terminal serviceability index of PD. So, the terminal serviceability index PD is the moodiness of the highway and the moodiness of the highway. And the highway is the same. ကားလမ်းမကြီးတွေဆိုရင်တော့ဒါအဓိကစားကားလမ်းမကြီးတွေဆိုရင်တော့ဒါပီဒီအ2x5ရသတိရှိတဲ့ဒီတဲ့ပုံပြီးတော့အစင်းနေတဲ့ဒီလိုနော်ခီဝေလိုင်းတွေမှာကျတော့ပီဝေရဆိုရင်တူးရှိတယ်နောက်ပြီးတော့မှစီးဝါရကန့်ကျက်တွေရှိနေတယ်ဆိုရင်တော့ပီဒီအ1x5တွေရှိတယ်အဲ့ဒီခါမှာဆိုရင်တော့ဒီလိုဟဆဝေးမှာသွားတဲ့ဒီကားနေပတ်သက်လို့ရစင်းစားမှာဖြစ်တယ်အဲ့ဒီခါမှာဆိုရင်တော့ဒီလိုနော်ကားတွေရဆ ညီမျှမှုရှိတယ်လဲဆိုတော့ဟိုဒီမော်တော်ကားတွေကိုတတ်မှာမှာဖြစ်တယ် Then we get to the data mine traffic load traffic load in terms of the equivalent 18,000 pounds are single axle loads ESEL all the traffic are had to be equivalent to 18,000 pounds single axle loads are ESEL Then we also know the concern about the robust size of the subgrade materials for the subgrade materials are CBR of the 10 or less in this case are bomba some in square is a 1500 CBR r of the 2 or 20 or less is a 1000 plus 555 margin r so in this case mr is a resilience are modulus those are the robust size in this case subgrade material are we rate by the mr MI says 1500 CBR or the MI says 1000 plus 555 multiplying R value. So MI says resilience and modulus. And so, the car out here, my kid, out here, my kid, out here, my kid, out here, my kid, out CBR, so it's a little bit of a new one. So, you know, MR is 1500 CBR. Here, Adamu is a little bit of a new one. So, you know, MR is 1000 plus 555 Adamu here. MR is resilient modulus. Talking about the material for the construction. In this case, we have to utilize layer coefficient. All the roads are we are layer by layer by layer. In this case, some base construction materials is A3, and base course are construction material A2, and surface course are construction material A1. So firstly, we have to put a surface, and then we have to use a base course, and then finally, we have to use a surface course. Those are construction materials you can classify by the A3, A2, and A1. In this case, the hot plant mix of the AC and the dense grade egg with the maximum size 1 are had to be utilized. Who said we pop ya ma or the DSOM PC Kriyari? Now, PC Kriyari, he is we are saying, not that Lea coefficient E in it, the matali. Now, a tala, a tala, your tummy. But the mazo sabi, your me, Okami, tummy, Tadakama DSOM PC, the answering A3, not the matali. Now, to go, Dudia, Okam, DSOM Mujado, A2, the matabi, or Apollo, Yanabi, DSOM Mujado, A1, the matala pity. Eddie Tamatakama bowing in it, Yavudu, Swaza, Yizari, a long bouncy bio, the road, a pro bound you up, low PC Kriyari. ဒီဆောင်မယ်ဆိုတော့ကိုဒါ A2 A1 A3 နဲ့သတ်မှတ်ဖို့ဖြစ်ထားတယ် We also need to concern about the environmental condition regarding the environmental condition we need to take in account on the temperature rainfall and the drainage the drainage factors N1 is also important for the construction of the road so drainage factor N1 is based on the passing of the tide during which the pavements are nearly saturated or the quality of drainage. Those things are also have to concern about. So the temperature, rainfall, drainage are there's environmental condition that are need to be concerned for there's constructing the highway. Not who are of Alaswin, the low, not high, a wavy line you, the South Kamas, not Bowinji and Chini, the lay, the Bob Bowinji and Chini, the Sinsama Pete, Eddie Kamas, a Pujin, the Muy, Jack Moody, W. Ye Tu Miauni, the Puma, Sinsame, Ye Tu Miauni, Ye Tu Namu, not Gangana, MI, 2000 people on Moody Lesro, the Eddie, the pavement day, not asking, not long, not low. ပြေဝလုံးဝလာတယ်အဲ့ဘလောက်ရအောင်ပြေဝလုံးဝတယ်အဲ့ဒါစဉ်းစားမယ်နောက်ပြီးတော့မှဒီကြာစင်းလာတဲ့ဒီလိုနောက်ပြေဝလုံးတဲ့ဒီ So definition of drainage quantity is that how the water remove within the 2 hours. We can remove the water within the 2 hours. The excellent, one day good, one week is fair, one month is poor, and water will not drain is very poor. So this is the important aspect. So the when the water cannot be drained, so in this case, the water can corrupt, erupt the road gradually. Therefore, the water removal time is very important for the drainage quality. The drainage quality determines the highway quality. Now, here you see the table 20.15. In this case, percentage time payments are exposed to the moisture level. So, in this case, the moisture level 1% composed this is fair, and 1.5%, 5.25%, greater than 25%. So in this case, the percentage of the recommend and my value for the water level. Now, this is the problem that we have to do. Now, this is the problem that we have to do. This is the problem that we have to do. And then we talking about the reliability of our percentage. Depending on the highway class and the region, so the SES are based on the crew rate. It may not be accurate. Other methods do not consider the uncertainty. So in this case, ASHDO consider the reliability factor, also possible uncertainty traffic condition performance prediction. In this case, when the reliability achieves a 50%, the design performance success is a 50%. So this will be depending on the variation in the traffic forecast. So this is the reliability that depends on the highway class region, on the assumed crew rate. And so that when we are designed for the settings are number of the car, but the car can be the car traffic volume will be increased. So this is the assumed growth rate, but it may not be accurate. In this case, we have to concern about the reliability factor. We only get the reliability 50%. The design performance are say only 50%. Those things are that are depending on the variation in the traffic forecast. And now we do about since I'm less in block, say charmless or since I'm a pity. And since I'm a swing, the don't let highway and Mozart in there, not don't you then near you, not don't since I'm a pity. Or yes, yeah, but it's when the non guardy block, do the lade, a year block, do the lade, since I'm. But I'm not do a guardy, a year of a man not cool, moody, your highway or the sign to women. Taking that, don't you the guy and Miala into a not the mulat. ခံမှန်းချက်ကတိကြတော့မှာမဟုတ်ဘူးအဲ့တော့အေအက်စ်တီကိုဝါဆိုရင်ဒါစိတ်ချမှုကိုစဉ်းစားမယ်စိတ်ချမှုဝါဆိုရင်เนาะဟိုစိတ်ချမှုဝါဆိုရင်เนาะဟိုတကယ်လို့เนาะအနာကမှာဒီလမ်းအခြေအနေကားအခြေအနေဘယ်လိုရှိလာလဲကြိုတင်ခန့်မှန်းပြီးလဲစဉ်းစားမှာဖြစ်တယ်အဲ့တော့စိတ်ချယုံကြည်မှုက 50%လာမယ်ဆိုတာเนาะချမ်းသာမှုကိုမှကြိုတင်ပြီးတော့စဉ်းစားမှုကလည်းပဲဒီလိုစိတ်ချမှု So in this case, we are talking about the standard deviation. The flexible payment is 0.4 to 0.5, and rigid payment is 0.3 to 0.4. And also, we also suggest the level of reliability for the various functional classification. For the in this case, we had to see about this urban and rural. Interstate and another freeway, so recommended level of reliability should be the urban is 85 to 99, rural is 80 to 99. So this is for the depending on the classification and function, we have to recommend the level of reliability. Eddie comes from flexible pavement, the swing to a standard deviation, 0.4 and 0.5 yashi, rigid payment, the yellow, 0.3 and 0.4 yashi. Now, look at the look. ကားတွေအဆုံးပြုတဲ့အမျိုးအစားကိုမူတည်ပြီးတော့မှဘယ်လောက်စိတ်ချရမလဲဆိုတာကိုလည်းသတ်မှတ်မှာဖြစ်တယ်။အဲသတ်မှတ်တဲ့ခါမှာဆိုရင်တော့မြို့နေတယ်မှာဆိုရင်တော့85နဲ့90 number 9တောတွေမှာဆိုတော့980နဲ့90 number 9အဲလိုတော့လူစိတ်ချယုံကြည်မှုကိုသတ်မှတ်မှာဖြစ်တယ်။ In this case we will use a standard normal deviation value corresponding to selected level of reliability. So for example reliability 99% mean standard deviation is around -2.327. အဲဒီမှာဆိုရင်တော့ဘာလဲဆိုရင် standard normal deviation တန်ဖိုးတွေအားဆိုရင်ဘလောက်စိတ်ချရမလဲဆိုတာကိုဆက်နွယ်နေတယ်။အဲစိတ်ချမှု99အရာကျွန်တော်ရှိတယ်ဆိုရင်တော့အဲ standard normal deviation အားဆိုရင် -2.327 ရှိတယ်။L to a drop as in then we are talking about the structural design. In this case structural design is depending on the A1 D1 plus A2 D2 M2 plus A3 D3 M3. In this case our D1 D2 D3 are the accuracy are thickness in inches of surface base and the surface course. Then we ခုဆက်ပြီးတော့ပေါ်ပြမှာတော့တိဆောက်မှုပုံစံကိုပေါ်ပြမယ်။တိဆောက်မှုပုံပြတဲ့အခါအဓိကညီမျှရင်အသုံးပြုလာအောင်ဆိုရင် SN = A1 D1 + A2 D2 M2 + A3 D3 M3 ဆိုရင်ညီမျှရင်နဲ့သုံးတယ်။အဲ့မှာ D1 D2 D3 ဒါဆိုရင်တော့ဗာလဲဆိုရင်ဒီမျက်နှာပြင်မှာရှိတဲ့အထူတွေအခြေတွေအထူတွေနောက်ပြီးတော့အောက်မှာရှိတဲ့နော် sub base တွေနော်အောက်ခံမြေသားတွေအထူတွေအဲ့ဒါတွေကိုသတ်မှတ်ပေါ်ပြထားတယ်။အဲ့ကောင်ဆိုတော့ပုံစံတိုးကွက်မယ်ဆိုတော့ပေးထားတဲ့အခြေအနေအရဆိုရင် then we have to calculate the example. So given factors are the flexible pavement, urban interstate highway, ESEA is a 2 margin tempo assist, a reef for the water to be drained within a moisture level 30%, so the MR of the ACA is 68 Fahrenheit is 45,000 PSI, CVR value of base is 100, MR is 31,000 PSI, CVR value of sub base is 22, MR is 135.00 PSI and the CBR subgrade is a 6. Those things that we are given in the problem. So, if you have the ASMA 25A, you can see the flexible payment, the urban interstates are interstate highway, the ESA are 2 margin tempo assist. And the Marshall level is 48,000 PSI ဖြစ်ပြီးတော့မှာ base 100ကိုအခြေခံထားတဲ့ဆိုရင် MR ဓာတ်မှ 31,000 PSI ရှိတယ်။အဲ sub base ကတော့ 22 ဖြစ်ပြီး MR ဆိုရင် 13500 PSI ဖြစ်ပြီးတော့ subgrade ရဲ့ CPR ကတော့ 6 ဖြစ်တယ်။ Then we calculate the firstly we have to determine the reliability. So use the table 20.10 reliability 99%, standard deviation 0.49 and this is PI is 4.5, PD 2.5, delta PSI is 4.5 minus 2.5 you got the 2. AY is equal to the 40 MR 45,000 PSI, AY 0.44, and for the user figure 20/70, and also the for the figure 20/16 data is 82.14, and for the figure 20/15 for the CVR 22 is 83.1, and then we use the figure 20/20, SN3 is 4.4 because of the MR 9,000 PSI, SN2 is 3.8, MR 13500 PSI, and SN1 is 2.6, MR 31,000 PSI. Those things are we can find out by using the figure 20/17, 20/16, 20/15, and 20/20. အဲ့တော့မှာ table 20/16ကိုအသုံးပြုတော့မှာစိတ်ချမှုရာ reliability 99% ဖြစ်တယ်။ standard deviation SO ကတော့ 0.49, 0.4 နဲ့ 0.5 ရာမှာရှိတယ်။ PN က 4.5, PD က 2.5 ရှိတယ်။အဲ data BSI ကတော့ 4.5 တဲ့ 2.5 နဲ့ 2 ရရှိမယ်။ figure 20/17ကိုအသုံးပြုတော့မှာ MR ဓာတ်မှု 45,000 PSI AC ဆိုရင် A1 0.44 ဖြစ်တယ်။ figure 20/16ကိုအသုံးပြုတော့မှာ CVR ဓာတ်မှု 100 က base ဖြစ်တယ်ဆိုရင် A2 က 0.14 ဖြစ်ပြီး figure 20/15ကိုအသုံးပြုတော့မှာ CVR ဓာတ်မှု 22 sub base ဆိုရင် AC က 0.1 ဖြစ်တယ်။အဲ့တော့မှာ figure 20/20ကိုအသုံးပြုတော့မှာ MR ဓာတ်မှု 9,000 အတွက် SN3 က 4.4 ဖြစ်သလို MR ဓာတ်မှု 13500 PSI အတွက်တော့ SN2 ဓာတ်မှုကဆိုရင် 3.5 ဖြစ်တယ်။ MR ဓာတ်မှု 31,000 PSI အတွက် SN1 အတွက် 2.6 ဖြစ်တယ်။And then we had to utilize that D1 equal to SN1 divided by A1, so 2.6 divided by 0.44, you got a 5.9. And D1 star is a 6, SN1 is A1, D1, so the 0.44 multiplied by 6 is 2.64. D2 is greater than the SN2 minus SN1 divided by A2, M2, greater than 3.8 minus 2.64, divided by 0.14 multiplied by 0.8, so you got this greater than 10.36. So we have to do a 12. And as I do that, value is a 0.14 minus 0.8 minus 12 plus 2164. You got a 1 by 34 plus 2166. You got a 0 by 98. T3 is equal to the SN3 minus SN2 divided by A3 M3. So you got a 4 by 4 minus 2164 plus a 1 by 34 divided by 0.1 minus 0.8. So you got a 5 by 25. So SN3 is equal to 2 by 464 plus 1 by 34 plus a 6 minus 0.8 minus 0.1. You got a 4 by 46. So that in this case, a source of concrete surface is a 6 inches, a granular base is 12 inches, and surface is 6 inches. So we can calculate the figure. Now, at maximum, D1 is SN1, A1 is sine, 2 by 6, 0.44 is sine, 5 by 9 yard. And at maximum, 6 lemma, so D1 is sine, but I'm not lia, so we have 6 lemma, so we concrete, and then we have 6 lemma, so we have 6 lemma. And now, SN1 is A1, D1 is needed, so we have 0.44 is 0.6 and 2 by 6, 4 yard. And D2 is more than SN2 is SN1, no, we have A2 M2 is sine, 2 by 6 minus 2 by 6, 4 by 0.14 is 0.8 is 10 by 6 yard, yard is 7 lemma, so we granular B as we send them a sheet of pity. So do these read them only SN3 and SN2. No, no, we are A3 M3 assigned 4 by 4 and we 2 by 6 ne 1 by 3 4 pound ne pound your map. Do pan at some point 1 and point in the whom you are solid swing 5 by 2 by yard address 6 inch pity. The number subway as we 6 inch pity. And my SN3 and what 2 by 6 4 year 1 by 3 4 year 6 k point 8 k point 1 and not alone point 4 by 4 6 go yashima pity. The figure 20.15 is a variation in granular survey layer coefficient with the various surface strength parameter. So depending on the surface strength parameter, we can determine the surface layer coefficient A3. And you must know, outcome is here, the tisamu, no, pamana di swan in ario, moody biroma, survey layer, no coefficient A3, the share at our figure 20.15 map of yard. This is for the figure 20.16. This diagram represents the variation in granular base layer coefficient with various surface strength parameters. So depending on the surface strength parameter, we can determine the variation in granular base layer coefficient A2. So when you see the surface strength, then we can determine this A2 coefficient. Granular base layer coefficient A2 at the moment is Yama Popiatala. This is the figure 20.17. So, this is the chart for the estimating the structural layer coefficient or dense graded as or concrete based on the elastic modulus. So, depending on the elastic modulus, we can determine the estimating the structural layer coefficient or the dense grade as or concrete based. Dima Popiatala figure 20.17 are Popiatala or Valesui elastic, not to ပြောင်းလေပြောင်းလေတဲ့เนาะဒီလို modular resilient modular ပေါ် moody ပြီးတော့မှာเนาะ asor concrete ရဲ့เนาะ subgrade layer coefficient ကိုเนาะရှာဖွေတဲ့เนาะဒီဇာယာကို figure 20/7 နေမှာဖော်ပြထားတယ် so this is for the figure 20/20 design chart for the flexible basement based on using the mean value of each input so that depending on the each input mean value we can determine the flexible pavement design chart. ဒီမှာဖော်ပြထားတဲ့အပုံကတော့ဖီကာ20/20ရှိတယ်အဲ့တော့ထည့်သွင်းလိုက်တဲ့ဒီလိုနော်မင်းဗယ်လူတွေထည့်သွင်းလိုက်တဲ့အင်ပွတ်တွေမှာရှိတဲ့နော်ပြောင်းပြချင်းတန်ဖိုးတွေမူတည်ပြီးတော့မှပြောလဲပြောင်းလဲရှိတဲ့ flexible pavement တွေကို ပုံစံကိုချတဲ့တွက်ချက်တဲ့ပုံစံဖြစ်တယ် you can see that this is a surface course and D2 base code and D1's are surface code. So SN3, SN2, SN1, we calculate. So this is the procedure for the determining the thickness of the layers during the layers analysis approach. Now, this is popular that not so aimed at SN3, SN2, SN1, D3, D2, D1, yeah, and I will achieve and be on my D2. အထအထတွေနဲ့အလွားနဲ့လို့တော့ဒီလမ်းဝင်နေရာချမှာဖြစ်တယ်ဆက်စားရင်base ကဒီ3ပြီးတော့မှာ base ကဒီ2နဲ့ surface ကိုဆက်လို့ဒီ1ဖြစ်တယ်အဲ့မြန်တဲ့ပြန်ဒီ1ဖြစ်တယ်အဲ့မှာ SN3 SN2 SN1 အဲ့ဒီညီမချင်းနေနဲ့သုံးပြီးတော့မှာတော့ဘလောက်အထူတွေလမ်းမှာအထူတွေဘလောက်ရှိရမယ်ဆိုတာကိုသတ်မှတ်ထားတယ်